Nice, yeah.
Might have split it open, huh?
Yeah, that's okay. Maybe it's not split open with the top.
Five, I just then do the percent, because that's 5
was just easier.
All right, thank you.
This is way more interesting than the jellyfish.
And you want to make sure to really separate, like, right here. Because if you do, then that's where all the organs are.
That's the tricky part, though. Yeah. Oh, here we go. Oh, here we go, here we go.
I just came to the party.
Yeah. Kind of hard, right? Okay, so I think I understand what the name is. Anybody heard of those birds before? They're on all types of aviates, which are the birds, and they're on reptiles. Because you guys are listening while you're dissecting, so crop and gizzard are found on various types of birds, reptiles, and obviously these guys, because they tend to either swallow their prey whole, they don't have teeth to be able to crush things, or like chickens, they tend to eat stuff that's on the ground, therefore swallowing dirt while they're eating it. It's kind of like you dropping a piece of chicken in the sand and then eating it, and then having to deal with like the crunchiness of like the sand in your mouth, right? Since chickens don't have teeth to be able to grind that stuff, they all have, including these guys, because these guys make it a lifestyle of eating dirt. They need to grind up that dirt. So imagine a garbage disposal pulverizing the stuff that you throw down there. Your crop and gizzard have these super strong muscles and almost rock-like structures in them that pulverize the dirt that's going through them. So that way it gets all mushed up like a mega Nutra blender or whatever. And then as it goes through the long intestine, all the yummies that the worm needs or the bird or whatever are absorbed out. And then the fresh, awesome nitrogen-rich dirt comes out of the anus. In a bird, there's a specific bird I'm thinking of, their crop works a little bit differently. They don't really have one. And because they can't digest those things and grind up bones of what they eat, they throw it up in a pellet form. Does anybody know what kind of bird that is?
Owl.
Owls. So owls will eat and swallow everything.
Equally.
And then in that little crop gizzard area, it just sits there. Everything else goes down, kind of like a garbage disposal that doesn't work properly. So you know how it like clogs And then if you let it sit long enough, the liquidy part and stuff just kind of drain. And then when that's all been pushed down and absorbed, the owl barfs up the rest. Which is why you find those cute little things and you're like, ooh, and you unwind it and unravel all the hair and everything, and there's like rat teeth in it and whatnot. Have you ever done that?
Oh yeah, I did.
It's like a ball of hair, and when you take it apart, you find like jaws and claws and like all kinds of stuff. So in worms, it's very similar. They're obviously the first ones to have this type of structure. So they grind up the dirt, and so that's why if you would like, anybody who's around the dissector, if you were able to actually expose it without slicing it open, you're more than welcome to grab a glove and take your finger and like rub it, because it kind of feels like a squishy jelly bean, gummy worm, I don't know. What else, how else would you describe it, Randy? It's the hardest thing in the worm that you're going to find. So if you'd like to do that, go ahead. Just make sure your surgeon steps away, your dissector steps away, so that you're able to feel it. Please only use one glove.